Ahoy there, pirates. Amir, One Falcon, here from Rare Thief. While the trading company progression system currently awards progress for turning in treasure, Seasons offers a different route for pirates to advance in the Sea of Thieves. The Seasons progression system awards progress to pirates for performing a wide variety of actions and not just turning in loot. The foundation of this global progression system is renown. Renown is a progression metric that isn't entirely dependent on handing in loot. Renown can be earned in dozens of different ways and represents your level of progress within a season. The higher your renown, the more cosmetics, gold, doubloons, and ancient coins you will unlock. So how can you raise your renown level? There are three main ways of earning renown and raising your renown level. Completing repeatable renown actions, completing one-time deeds and trials, and completing special events. Let's start with renown actions. You and your crew can complete specific actions while pirating around the Sea of Thieves and raise your renown. These actions range from basic actions such as sailing nautical miles to more difficult actions like completing world events. Many of these actions will naturally happen as you explore the sea and combat threats you come across. Other actions will require you to focus your efforts on them if you want to earn the renown they offer. Some renown actions will give renown to your entire crew. Actions such as bringing treasure on board, killing skeletons, and scuttling skeleton ships will award renown to you and your crew when performed. Other renown actions such as catching fish, eating meat, and visiting islands will award renown to just the pirate who did it. You will be notified each time you complete an action that rewards renown with a notification in the top corner of the screen. Every time you see a notification with the words added to log in them, you'll know you have earned some renown. As mentioned, some renown actions are more difficult to perform and award a different amount of renown. Renown actions belong to one of three difficulty tiers: Swift, Grand, and Epic. Swift renown actions, such as placing treasure on your ship, will be labeled with a green logbook in the notification. These renown actions will give you the least amount of renown a renown action can award. Grand renown actions, such as vanquishing a skeleton captain or completing a voyage, will be labeled with a blue logbook in the notification. These renown actions will give a medium amount of renown a renown action can award. Epic renown actions, such as scuttling a skeleton ship or completing a world event, will be labeled with a purple logbook in the notification. These renown actions will give the highest amount of renown a renown action can award. Not every action you can perform in the game will award renown, but there are a ton of them that do. The following actions are the actions we discovered to award renown so far. Visiting islands. Visiting islands is one of the swift renown actions you can perform. Each time you visit an island, you will receive renown. You simply need to set foot on the island for the action to trigger. A cooldown will prevent you from immediately hopping back on your ship and jumping on the island again. You'll need to wait some time and visit other islands before returning to acquire more renown. Another swift renown action is sailing nautical miles. You'll be awarded renown for each nautical mile you sail. Though, you must be physically on the ship for the mile counter to track. You cannot be off the ship while it sails around the sea and receive credit for the miles the ship logs without you. The next actions are all treasure related and all swift renown actions: digging up treasure, placing treasure on your ship, and selling treasure. For each piece of treasure you and your crew dig up, you will receive renown. This can be treasure from a voyage or a message in a bottle. As long as you're digging up a piece of treasure, you will get the renown. It's one thing to dig up a piece of treasure, it's another to safely get it onto your ship. Placing pieces of treasure on your ship for the first time will award you and your crew renown. However, you cannot take the same piece of treasure off and on to keep racking up renown. It will only trigger the first time for that particular piece of treasure. Now that you've dug up treasure and placed it on your ship, it's now time to sell it. You will gain renown for each piece of treasure you hand in to a trading company. You and your crew will earn the renown for selling treasure, so it doesn't matter who does the selling. These next two actions are skeleton related. Vanquishing skeletons will award you and your crew renown. Any skeletons will do. Defeating emergent skeletons, Order of Souls skeletons, Skeleton Fort skeletons, or any other skeleton will count for the renown. Something different about this action, though, is it only counts for every 10 skeletons you kill. For every 10, you and your crew will be awarded with an epic amount of renown. If you want to earn even more renown for skeleton slaying, you want to keep an eye out for any skeleton captains, Ashen Guardians, or Ashen Keymasters. Defeating one of these types of skeletons counts as a grand renown action and will award you with additional renown. Alright, time to switch it up and go fishing. Each fish you catch counts as a swift renown action and will give you renown. Keep in mind though, catching fish awards personal renown and not crew renown. While catching any fish will raise your renown, catching a trophy fish will get you extra renown. Catching a trophy fish counts as another swift renown action and will award you with renown on top of the renown for catching fish in general. Two renown actions for the price of one. Once you have some raw meat in hand, be it the fish you just caught, or chicken, snake, or pork, or monster meat, cook it up and receive renown. It must be golden brown and perfectly cooked when you take it off the stove for it to count as a grand renown action. If it is raw or burnt, you won't receive the credit for the action. While cooking regular meat will award you with renown, you will get bonus renown if it is monster meat. Cooking up a piece of megalodon meat or kraken meat is another grand renown action and will give you renown on top of the renown you get for cooking regular meat. That's another two for the price of one. Now that you have all this perfectly cooked meat, you can either eat it or sell it. Each time you take a bite of perfectly cooked meat, you will be awarded with renown. Eating raw meat or burnt meat will not give you any renown. The meat must be golden brown when you eat it for it to count as a swift renown action. As it takes two bites to eat a piece of meat, you can expect to be awarded renown twice for each piece. If you choose to sell it, you'll want to take the meat to the closest sea post and sell it to the Hunter's Call representative. Each piece of meat you sell counts as a swift renown action and will award you renown. That's about it for fishing. Time for voyages and tall tales. Completing chapters of a voyage or checkpoints in a tall tale both count as a grand renown action. Completing an entire voyage or an entire tall tale also counts as a grand renown action and will award you with renown. Time to move on to sea combat. The next time you get trapped in ink, think of it as a blessing from the pirate lord himself. Each tentacle you injure counts as a grand renown action. The more tentacles you take out, the more renown you and your crew gets. If you take down enough tentacles to defeat the kraken, you will have performed an epic renown action. You'll also want to stick around and pick up all the kraken meat it leaves behind for additional renown when cooked. You should start thinking of that kraken as a renowned pinata that you can't wait to blast open. Moving on to the megalodon. They are also worth a fair amount of renown if you can kill one, as it counts as an epic renown action. You'll also want to pick up the megalodon meat they leave behind to cook it up for some extra renown. Those pesky skeleton ships now have an extra reason to be taken down as well. Each skeleton ship you and your crew sinks counts as an epic renown action and will award you with renown. It doesn't matter if it's a sloop or galleon skeleton ship, it's an epic sink no matter what. Ghost ships, on the other hand, are not so epic. Each ghost ship you scuttle will award you and your crew with renown for completing a swift renown action. They do only take 3 shots to defeat. Swift sounds about right. Time for the big one. Completing any one of the world events will award you with renown for completing an epic renown action. Clearing a skeleton fort, sinking the captain of a skeleton fleet, defeating the Burning Blade, or taking down an Ashen Lord will give you and your crew a nice chunk of renown. You will also be earning renown along the way as you complete the world event from killing skeletons, sinking skeleton ships, and sending those ghost ships back to the Sea of the Damned. With all of those renown actions available, you'll be earning renown left and right, climbing up the season's renown levels with ease. The next main way to earn renown is through deeds and trials. Trials allow another path for pirates to earn renown. They are comprised of deeds, which are one-time tasks that you can complete for renown. Unlike the repeatable renown actions, these can only be completed once for the season. These tasks range from simple activities such as cooking a fish to larger activities like completing every tall tale. For each deed in a trial you complete, you will receive renown. You will also earn renown when the entire trial has been completed. You can view all the available trials in the pirate log in-game. You will find 4 categories of trials here: adventure, exploration, combat, and sea. Regardless of your playstyle, you are sure to find a trial suited to your pirate's preferences. Similar to renown actions, deeds and trials will reward different levels of renown based on their difficulty tier. Epic deeds and trials will reward the highest amount of renown, while the grand deeds and trials will reward less than the epic. Swift deeds and trials are the easiest of the 3 different difficulty tiers. Thus, the swift deeds and trials will reward the least amount of renown. Overall though, deeds and trials award much more renown than renown actions do. You want to find some deeds you'd like to complete to work on them if you want some big renown gains. The 3rd main way to earn renown is by participating in special events. From now on, special events will not only award players with cosmetics, but also renown. As for the best way to advance your renown level, the difficulty tiers and the time commitments for the renown actions and trials are fairly balanced. When you start to look at what activities to do to earn the most renown at once, we think that completing world events is a great way to level up your renown. Taking on a skeleton fort, for example, will allow you to kill skeletons, an epic renown action, kill skeleton captains, a grand renown action, complete a world event, an epic renown action, and then place all the treasure from the vault onto your ship. Lots of swift renown actions. For pirates who don't like the attention a world event brings on themselves, fishing seems like another good bet. Catching fish is a swift renown action, bonus renown for a trophy fish, cooking a fish perfectly is a grand renown action, and then eating or selling it for another swift renown action. The deeds and trials also award a large amount of renown on their own, as we mentioned. So if you're able to combine performing renown actions while you complete the deeds, you are well on your way to level 100. That's about it from us on raising your renown. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments below. Thanks for watching.